I'm going to derive the lever rule, which we use often when we're looking at two phases in equilibrium, and we know the overall composition, and we want to know how much of each phase do we have. So I'm showing you a pressure mole fraction diagram. This is taken from this interactive simulation. I've given you the link, and this interactive simulation basically solves the lever rule, and then the relative size of these colored rectangles in a bar graph on the right indicate how much of each phase, but we want to determine how that calculation, the lever rule, arrived, how it was derived. And what we're going to do for the lever rule is say the total number of moles of one of the components, so the total moles of B is equal to the moles of B in the liquid plus the moles of B in the vapor. So just the mass balance on B, it has to be in either liquid or vapor. We'll use the notation L to represent the amount of liquid, V to represent the amount of vapor. The mole fraction for this case, X sub B, is the liquid phase mole fraction, Y sub B is the vapor phase, and then where that black dot is, that's the overall. So we'll call that ZB. So total number of moles, we have liquid plus vapor, so total number of moles in the system is the number of moles of liquid, number of moles of vapor. If we multiply that by the mole fraction for the total amount, that's now the moles of B in our system. The moles of B in the liquid phase, number of moles of liquid, times X sub B, moles of B in the vapor phase, number of moles of vapor, times Y sub B. So all we have to do is rearrange this, and it'll look like the commonly used lever rule. So I'm going to bring the term with L, left side of the equation, and so ends up like so. And then the right side, I'm going to move the ZB term times vapor, so as a minus sign. So this is the lever rule. What it's saying is L times this ZB minus XB, which is that. So let me call that A. L times A is V, the amount of vapor, times B. B is YB minus ZB. So the lever rule just follows from a mass balance, and we use it often when we're trying to determine amounts in phases. It does not just have to be liquid and vapor that are in equilibrium, but it only applies when we have two phases in equilibrium.